Okay, so I've been meaning to play this game for a long, long time here. You have to understand the thing about it is I once played this game a long time ago on PlayStation 2, and unfortunately the copy that I had was scratched when I purchased it, and I was only able to play maybe halfway through the game. So yet here I've decided to play it again and put it on YouTube for everyone to see. If you're okay with old school. Okay, well, sorry, I had to let that one play through. I didn't want to talk all the way through it. But as you can see, I mean, this is an older game. It's PlayStation 2 era. I bought it today for about $5 because it was on sale, and I've been meaning to get it for a while anyways. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and get into this. I would explain the storyline, but you guys are gonna see this because this is gonna be my first Let's Play series. So, we'll see how this goes. I'm gonna go ahead and start the new game. Which, obviously, what else are we gonna do, right? It's just, like, it's so crazy that I'm really happy this is on the PlayStation Network. Like, I've been wanting to finish this game for so long. I mean, it might just be nostalgia. Nostalgia, whatever you want to call that. It might just be that glossing it over, and I might be remembering the game to be better than it was, but if I'm not mistaken, it made me think, you know, on several spots. So, you know, we'll get into this and we'll see where it goes. Oh, also, the band that did the soundtrack is called 16 Volt. So, if you are interested in the music that is playing, which I definitely was, it's really good music. The band is 16 Volt. They're the ones responsible for it. I'm gonna kind of let this play itself out.
Every day, every hour, every day, every hour, every day, 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 Sorry, babe. Hey. Hey, Lewis, what's up?
This cute freak in the crowd kept staring at me. Like some whacked out psycho.
Well, maybe you never checked out your audience before, but you guys don't exactly share the same fan base as Kenny G.
Oh, this was different. He looked seriously creepy.
Ooh, that reminds me. Grab your money and let's split. We gotta go visit the landlord.
Great set, man.
Come on. If we don't pay him tonight, we're gonna be living in a box.
Ah, Jen. You never used to complain. I think we grew in a pot.
I'm 21 now, Lewis. Too old to be living like a bum. Plus, I'm gonna need study space once I start college. No autographs, creep.
Good night, guys. See you next time.
See you, buddy.
I apologize for the long bouts of silence. I really don't like talking through cutscenes because I feel like if you are watching this, you might actually be interested in what's going on. So if I let those play out, you know, it'll be better for you to get an understanding of the game.
Is this your Jane Doe?
Yeah, came in 2 nights ago. Hasn't come round yet. She's a fighter, though. I've lost plenty with injuries less than hers.
5 broken ribs, lung punctured in 2 places, ruptured spleen. What'd you do, get hit by a truck?
Yeah, she left some nightclub with her boyfriend. Yeah, looks like a gang jumped them. Left her lying outside the club. They found him several blocks away. He's in the room 3 doors down.
So, what do you think?
50-50.
Come on, Doctor. There's a coffee and donut downstairs. Need your attention.
That was one freaky dream. This, hospital? What the hell happened? Oh my God. I'm dead? No, I don't want to be dead. Things were just starting to work out. Lewis and I were just... Oh my God. Lewis. What happened to us? Huh? What the hell are you? A bit short for the Grim Reaper, aren't ya?
You're not dead, Jennifer. But if you don't be quiet and listen to me, you soon will be. My name is... Well, let's say you can call me Scree. I've been sent to find you, to show you some very important things, and to enlist your assistance.
Right. Well, Scree... Glad I'm not dead. But first you better explain how come I'm looking down on myself. She is creeping me out.
Your corporeal form, the one still lying there, is very weak, close to death perhaps, but not yet lost. That is only part of you. The other part, your spirit. That's you. I set it free from your body so that we could talk. In fact, now that it's free, you'll find you can travel to places you've never even imagined.
Right, so I'm like an astral projection or something.
Essentially, yes.
So what does that make you?
I am but a humble servant to my lady, and to you I'm a friend, someone you need to trust. Now quickly, you must come with me. We're both vulnerable here.
Okay, but only because I'm intrigued. I've never been an astral projection before.
Okay, Jennifer.
What the hell? My God. What just happened? Where are we?
Questions, questions. We're no longer in Mortalis. We've stepped through a rift gate into the Nexus.
Still, huh?
As I said earlier, your spirit is no longer constrained by flesh. You have left the physical mortal world and now stand in the Nexus, a convergence point for energies drawn from the four realms of Oblivion.
Sounds like one of Lewis's fantasy novels.
This is real, Jennifer. I know you mortals think you're at the heart of everything, but believe me, you're not. Now please try to absorb all of this quickly. There really is no time to waste.
Okay, I'm trying. Just one thing, though. No matter where we are, you gotta stop calling me Jennifer. You sound like my stepdad. It's Jen.
I am to give you these. They are devices that will help you to learn of your true self. And if my lady is correct, they may afford us some protection.
What am I supposed to do with this?
It's a vambrace. They fasten around your wrists. Please, it's important that you trust me and just put them on.
I've just jumped out of my skin, left my body in some hospital, been dragged through a rift gate.
Rift gate?
And I'm in Oblivion. Vambrace? Not a problem.
Precisely.
Ooh, shiny. And pretty comfy for a pair of metal doodads. Could have been made for me.
They were.
So, how do I get them off?
You don't.
And this guy wants me to trust him. This lady you keep mentioning, who is she?
I serve Arella. She is all that is good and pure. She is strength and virtue. She is righteousness. She is nobility.
She's a person, right?
She is not a person. She is not mere flesh and bone, emotion and desire. She is one of two primal forces that govern the universe. She is order.
And the other would be...
The other would be Abaddon. The embodiment of chaos. Lord of corruption and decay. He is my lady's eternal foe and the reason for my being.
Right. You know you're gonna have to introduce me to this Arella.
Oh, I shall. And she will be most relieved to see you. But first, I must show you more of Oblivion. Please follow me.
Scree, will all this start making sense anytime soon? Is there nothing you can say that won't leave my head spinning?
I think that perhaps your Lewis may have been brought here.
Lewis? Lewis here? You've got to help me find him.
Oh, okay. So, I know this game looks like a certain kind of something. I think my camera's inverted. I know it looks, it might not be too entertaining, but you can't expect it to look great,
come
like
on,
I said.
This way.
PlayStation 2 era. Hang on a second. And forgive me if I'm a little lost, because I really don't remember that much. Oh, Jesus, camera's so shaky. So, a little background. If I'm not mistaken, this is made by a university. I can't remember which one. And I think it took them about 3 years, and I know it had a second release. There's a Primal 2. So, I'll probably try to get a hold of that.
So, they got one of these.
If this goes well.
With the might of chaos and order eternally battling, a balance between them must also be fought for. Here at the heart of the Nexus is where that happens. Drawing in the two primal forces, governing, generating a safe parallel energy, that is the awesome responsibility of Kronos.
And awesome's the word for this gadget. Oh, there's someone in the middle of all that.
As I said, Jen, Kronos.
Jeez, he's looking at me.
Perhaps he can hear you, too.
Well... I'm sure the guy's doing a great job in there. On there. Oh my god, Scree, he's plugged into the damn thing.
It is an ancient machine, with Kronos living at its heart. There are four realms in Oblivion, Jen. Two aligned with order and two with chaos. Each realm has its own natural balance, eternally generating the right levels of primal energy, which is drawn into the Nexus and fed through Kronos to Arella and Abaddon. Kronos has eternally governed with wisdom and impartiality, channeling balanced strength to them both. Without him, the Nexus, Oblivion, and your Mortalis wouldn't exist at all. Simple as that.
You know, if I was as wise as this Kronos, I'd find a cushier job. Pull out the jacks and swing in the hammock for a while.
For all our sakes, I trust your own sense of responsibility matches your distinctive sense of humor.
Distinctive good or distinctive?
Distinctive inappropriate.
Jeez, I'm being heckled by a troll. Is he okay? That doesn't look too healthy.
Force of chaos is overpowering him. Abaddon is putting his ancient plan into practice, a break with eternity. He's secretly corrupting the kingdoms of order, strengthening the realms of chaos, foolishly rocking the Nexus like a boat about to capsize. Just look at our guardian suffering to keep control. He may not last very long. Come on, Jen, we have no time to lose.
Okay, I'm coming. Just don't leave me behind here.
Well, okay, I think I'm gonna end up cutting the entire prologue and all these cutscenes. I think I just found a collectible. The entire prologue and all these cutscenes into one video. And then the actual level in the next area. Oh, it's just a rock. What is it? I think those were called lodestones? I think they're for restoring some kind of energy. Not 100% sure. But I do know there's collectibles, and I do want to try and get a few. I'm not going to, you know, spend my entire time. I'll probably cut out all the parts where I'm searching the environment if need be. I probably shouldn't go exploring. Oh, I lost him. Oh, he's up there. But, I mean, this was, like, top of the line at its time. And like I said, I think it took 3 years to develop in a university, of all places. I do really want to do a sequel. So I hope this whole series goes well. I know not many people are even subscribed to the channel, but, you know, whatever I can do. I know this might not even interest some of you, so even if it only gets, like, 4 views, I'll still be happy with it. I'll probably watch it again. But yeah, I think I'm going to cut out the entire epilogue and put that in its own video.
It's no good. I'm gonna have to ask Scree.
Questions again. And if there's something I'd want you to ask, you never do. What, please?
These symbols.
Ah.
I presume you have noticed this.
Indeed, there is a remarkable similarity.
They are identical, you lunk. Louis drew the design for me just after we met. How come the symbol's all over the place here?
I simply can't tell you.
Can't or won't?
It's branded on you, Jen, not me. I don't know everything.
It's not branded, it's just a tattoo, goddammit. Louis told me it was a ancient rune of protection. I just thought it looked cool.
Where did Louis see this symbol? It's very important.
He wouldn't tell me. Oh, forget it. Everything else going on, that ain't gonna freak me out. Come on, little guy.
The animation is so bad. Okay. So I think I'm gonna go through here, have another cutscene, and I will, you know, I'll end the video.
Where are we now?
We have entered the kingdom of Solum. Time stands still in the four realms connected to the Nexus. In this realm, it is eternal night.
And let me guess. Eternal winter?
By nature, Solum is bleak of climate, but nothing too harsh for its people. The Ferae are strong and resourceful hunters.
You say hunters?
The worlds of Oblivion are each inhabited by a different race, and yes, the Ferae are fierce, sometimes brutal, but they are fundamentally good. You're going to meet a lot worse, I assure you.
Splendid.
Solum and its people have always been aligned with order, providing my Lady Arella with power.
But now things have gotten screwed up, right?
Yes, thanks to Abaddon's villainy. His interference in the realms is drawing all the primal energy to his side and starving my lady of her very existence. In truth, neither side can survive without the other, and soon everything will be destroyed.
So the guy's trashing the status quo, creating chaos. Guess he's doing his job.
And we must do ours, so just listen.
Oops.
I'm sorry. You must forgive me for that, Jen. So much more will become clear to you, child, but we've so little time.
Hey, look, don't sweat it. I'm fine. So what's to be done here? Let's get on with it.
Thank you, Jen. Right, now, what we've got to do here, Jen, is... I haven't the faintest idea. But I do know Solum has been tainted by chaos somehow, and we have to restore the natural order. I told you the Ferae are violent, but they live as a basically peaceful clan with rituals and art, for example, a structured society. The one crucial thing for the race is their king. In Solum, the king has huge authority, awesome strength, but he must, without fail, sacrifice himself at the height of his power and pass the throne to his heir.
Gruesome.
Ah, yes, the burning crown. The traditional method of royal sacrifice. Failure of the king to abdicate his power would devastate the land and lead its people to ruin.
Ruin as in?
Precisely. The king here is Hearn, strong, deadly even, but always a good leader for his people, I believe. A Ferae king like any other through eternity. But some time ago, he was due to relinquish power.
And he's running for another term.
He is senselessly refusing to give up his rule, and so leading the Ferae to disaster.
So we check it out. Cool.
Yes. A sound plan of action.
Okay. Well... since there was like, you know, maybe, I don't even know how much, it was a long time for, you know, just cutscenes. So, unfortunately, I'm just going to cut this one short and this will just be like the epilogue, filler, whatever, so you can learn the backstory because I don't see much point in playing that much of, you know, cutscenes and then hardly any gameplay. I don't know quite how long I'm going to end up making these episodes yet, but in a perfect world, I will be able to do maybe one realm per video. So that would leave it like maybe 4 or 5 videos. I don't know just yet. So, yeah. I'm going to sit here and figure out how to save this, and we'll carry on.